So we're looking today at some of our weed management trials in soybeans. A similar but yet different story than what we evaluated and talked about in the corn weed management trial. Planting dates around the end of May, May 26th or so. And what we find again is we went into a dry period where not all of our pre-emergence products were activated quick enough to get complete control or control of some of our really tough weeds like giant ragweed. They were successful in controlling some of our small seeded weeds like lamb's quarters, water hemp, and some of the grasses, but we certainly saw misses in our giant ragweed. Some differences. When we compare into the corn weed management, we spoke a lot about reach back. Once we have the rainfall, we get reach back and we see some of those herbicide chemistries being able to take down weeds that are already emerged. We don't have quite that same flexibility in the soybeans. Those herbicides don't have the reach back, but they do have what I would call reach forward. We put them on for the residual activity. We want them to continue to work for us during the growing season, and that's what we see now. Here are some comparisons. If we did not use the pre-emergence herbicides, we were looking at putting our first early post 4 days after those beans emerged. So we planted on the 26th, they emerged on June 5th, but by June 9th, we needed to get that post-emergence on to take those small weeds out and small matchbook size weeds like giant ragweed, lamb's quarters, water hemp. We needed to be there to have successful control. With our pre-emergence that were successful, it still bought us about 3 to 4 weeks time before we needed to put our post. And our best performers, we're still waiting. We will have maybe 4 or 5 weeks before we need to put that post-emergence control on. In summary again, let's review why it's so important to use that pre-emergence product in our soybeans. First, it does reduce the density of certain weed species and in many cases takes out the complete flush of other weeds like our small seeded broadleaves. So it's helping you there. It opens that window of time that you need to get your post-emergence program on. It may be different each year. You need to scout your field and watch for how those weeds are coming through because of the rainfall and when products are activated. But it may buy you 2, 3, 4 weeks of time before you need to come back with that post-emergence program. So you decrease the density, you decrease the number of species, and it does buy you needed time during the summer of spring. So one last reminder, folks always ask, was it worth putting that pre-emergence on? Well, if you have a skip in your field, you can see it. It is always worth that. It does maybe not reach back, but we look at reaching forward to continue to control weeds with those residual products through that growing season.